It's even better than it was pitched, and it is even more complicated.
WandaVision, strict rules the cast has to follow. The Marvel Cinematic Universe, or the MCU, is a complex 23-film, over 40 superheroes, 4 phases, and over 3,000 minutes of action-packed entertainment that has collectively grossed over $17 billion. Disney actually purchased the franchise back in 2009 for $4 billion. WandaVision, the latest addition to the franchise, tells the story of Wanda Maximoff, played by Elizabeth Olsen, and Vision, played by Paul Bettany. But have you ever wondered what it is to be a star on WandaVision? Hey everyone, and welcome back to Celeb Mania. You don't want to miss this exclusive coverage as we take a glimpse at the life of an MCU star. So make sure you stay until the end, and let's begin. Number 8. Must act like a superhero on and off screen. Imagine being Vision off screen. What with him being an AI personal assistant placed into his synthetic body, Scarlett Johansson has maintained this image by working with charitable organizations such as USA Harvest and Oxfam that feed people from impoverished third world countries. Mark Ruffalo stepped up to the plate when he brought more attention to the Standing Rock protests with his opposition of the Dakota Access Pipeline. Ruffalo would regularly join the natives of Standing Rock during their protests, and even donated 2 Navajo-made solar trailers to provide shelter, heat, and power for the protesters during the winter months. Good luck pulling something like this in the real world, Vision. Number 7. Cannot perform any stunts deemed too dangerous. Everyone wants to see their favorite superhero perform their own stunts. And when you have competition with DC World, remember, Batman, Superman actors doing their own stunts made for good publicity. But MCU has a different take on this. For Marvel, they must follow these rules because they are practically irreplaceable during filming, and any serious injuries could severely hinder the production process. This also allows Marvel to save some money that would otherwise go to covering costly insurance for their actors. Disney contractually prohibits MCU actors from performing any stunts that have been declared too hazardous by the higher-ups. Hence, when you see Wanda destroying a building and other stunts, you know it's probably not her, but a stunt double actually doing it. Number 6. Hit the gym, keep fit, and have extensive fight training. MCU actors are required to complete demanding workout routines every day and maintain a strict diet, specifically formulated to mold them into a superhero physique. Most Marvel actors are obligated to log around 2 hours of gym time a day and keep a diet consisting of mainly boiled chicken and dried oats. These requirements are taken very seriously, and actors are given warnings if they miss even a single workout. Chris Pratt famously went through a complete body transformation when he got the role of Star-Lord in Guardians of the Galaxy. Known as a slightly plump comedian, he worked out judiciously to lose weight and tone up, and has been remarkably candid in interviews about the process. As well as hitting the gym to ensure they look like superheroes on screen, many MCU actors will also be expected to take part in the extensive fight training exercises for the movie's action scenes. For Black Panther, Chadwick Boseman was trained in martial arts by Maurice Crump in Tampa, Florida. He also worked with Jiu-Jitsu Grandmaster Bill McLeod in Brooklyn, New York, and later attended a fight camp with Marvel's fight choreographers before filming began. This was all on top of the already enduring 5-hour workouts with a conditioning coach that he underwent with for months on end. Number 5. Endure a lengthy makeup process. Ouch! This one must be tasking for Paul Bettany. He plays the burgundy-faced android with the Mind Stone, a yellow infinity stone located on Vision's forehead. A similar case was of Karen Gillan, the actress who plays alien Nebula in the Guardians of the Galaxy movies. Shaved her head completely bald and endured 4 hours and 15 minutes in the makeup chair every morning on the first film. She had to have a 5-part prosthetic applied and also wore 22mm contact lenses. Thankfully, the process was refined on the sequel, and her time in the chair was reduced to 2.5 hours, and only the back of her head being shaved. Anyways, for both Paul and Karen, this is a considerable amount of time even before starting the workday, and imagine being in it for the rest of the day. Number 4. Be prepared for reshoots. As if a lengthy makeup and long working hours in that makeup was not enough, now the actors have to be prepared at any time for reshoots as and when required. Although reshoots are commonplace on most sets, they're taken very seriously by Marvel. Another obligation written into MCU contracts concerns reshoots. Namely, actors must make themselves available for them if called upon. Sometimes when the director is assembling a film, they might realize they need more shots to make everything flow better, or entire new scenes might need to be filmed to incorporate new story elements. Reshoots in the MCU are prevalent due to the complexities that emerge as several different storylines intersect. In order to maintain continuity across the franchise, reshoots are often needed as the overarching plot evolves. As a part of their contract, all MCU actors are obligated to show up for reshoots, regardless of what project they might currently be working on. It particularly angered Idris Elba, who publicly spoke of how filming reshoots as Heimdall in Thor: The Dark World, only a day after playing Nelson Mandela in Long Walk to Freedom, didn't sit well with him. His exact words when talking to his agent were, "It ripped my heart out. This is enduring, man. I don't want to do this." Number 3. No spoilers, no scripts. Confidentiality is everything. Elizabeth Olsen, who plays Wanda Maximoff in WandaVision, was interviewed on Jimmy Kimmel Live in April 2018 and revealed some surprising details on Marvel's quest for secrecy regarding Avengers: Infinity War. She said certain cast members were offered the chance to read the full script, but this had to be done in 1 5-hour sitting on an iPad in an empty room after checking in your cell phone at the door. She thought this process sounded unpleasant, so just asked for Marvel to give her Wanda's pages. Now, there were some cast members who did choose to do that private read, and this included big stars like Robert Downey Jr., aka Iron Man, and Benedict Cumberbatch, aka Doctor Strange, with Paul Bettany, who plays Vision, alongside Elizabeth, then revealed that other cast members were even given fake scripts with erroneous plot twists in order to prevent real details leaking. You might have read about these in the Cold War era. What will all the Russian and American spies running the war? Talk about protecting your trade secrets. MCU certainly knows how to keep theirs. Number 2. Hidden shooting locations in unmarked vans. Taking the confidentiality clause a bit too seriously are MCU. Elizabeth Olsen was also refreshingly honest about some of the tactics used by Marvel to maintain privacy while filming Avengers: Infinity War. At Ace Comic Con in Seattle, she and Paul Bettany were interviewed by geek icon Kevin Smith, and Olsen revealed she had absolutely no idea what was supposed to happen during Infinity War's ending until the very day they filmed it. Directors Joe and Anthony Russo bundled all the actors into an air-conditioned van, told them the ending, and then revealed they were traveling to the shooting location right then and there. This must be difficult for actors, as they constantly need to be able to adapt and get into their character's headspace on the fly, without all the knowledge that could potentially help their performance. Now we can expect WandaVision doing the same to her and Paul, since no spoilers is still top agenda of Disney, and they certainly don't want their first OTT release to breach a highly profitable future market. Number 1. Multiple subcontracts in one contract. Both Elizabeth and Paul have appeared as Wanda and Vision, respectively, in previous MCU movies, so this one is a given that they might already have multi-movie deals in a single contract. It's common practice for MCU lead actors to sign multi-picture deals. One of the more publicly discussed is that of Samuel L. Jackson, who signed up for a whopping 9 films as Nick Fury. The number of movies other actors have on their contracts isn't as well known, though it's been reported that 6 film deals are the norm these days. Marvel is keen to sign actors to multiple films because, if they go on to become important members of the universe, it lessens the need for contract renegotiations at a later date. This might be majorly due to what they endured with Robert Downey Jr., aka Iron Man, the linchpin of the entire MCU. He had initially signed a 4-picture deal, but has by now appeared in a total of 9 MCU films. That means his contract has been renegotiated multiple times, with a few extra zeros added on each time, no doubt. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification button to get updates on our latest videos. And while you're here, go ahead and check out one of these 2 videos on your screen. See you there!